Welcome back to my Road to Completion Guide for Elden Ring. This is episode 5. Follow me to the lift so we can reach the upper level. It's possible to skip the enemies, but the safe play is to kill them all. Pull the switch to open the boss arena. Go back to the site of grace to refill your flask. If you still have plenty of flask, you can go directly to the boss arena. Summon and spam Rock Sling to defeat the boss. This will unlock a summon called Lutel the Hudless, which gives us credit toward a trophy. Make sure to avoid his projectile to stay mobile. Fast travel back to the Tombsward Catacombs. Ride to the church and grab another sacred tear. Fast travel to the Castle Morn Rampart site of grace. Follow the path up the hill and grab the sacred tear. Killing the enemies is optional. Find a safe spot without enemies and fast travel to the Castle Morn lift. Follow me to activate the Site of Grace behind the castle. walk slowly off the platform and pick up the stone sword key. We can activate another side of Grace before the next boss. Just make sure to clear the rats at the bottom of the tower with Rotten Breath and Rock Sling for safe passage. Skip the jellyfish enemies and make your way to the fog gate. Summon, keep your distance, and kill the boss with Rock Sling so we can get the Grafted Blade Greatsword. This sword gives us credit toward another trophy. Fast travel back to Stormhill Shack. Head north and follow my path to the lake-facing cliffs side of Grace. Now's our chance to get the Round Table Hold Trophy.
Very well. Let my hand rest upon you.
Visit the Twin Maiden Husk and buy a Memory Stone plus 3 Stone Sword Keys. Talk to the blacksmith and ask about the girl.
You're a new face. No matter. Lay out your arms. Curly boy here. She's crestfallen and concerned. She has a gift. I saw another one like her. Her eyes share the same hue.
Speak with the girl and tell her what the blacksmith said, then exhaust the rest of her dialogue.
A pleasure to meet you. My name is Roderica. Isn't this place impressive? The Round Table Hold. I never knew the guidance bestowed, although I'm still looking for my own, but you're telling me I possess some kind of gift? I don't believe you. If I do have this talent, I suppose I should try to hone it, shouldn't I? I'll ask Master Hugh to teach me. Certainly he does appear intimidating. I know he's trapped here, and I can tell. If I do have a talent for spirit, I suppose I should try to hone. I'll ask Master Hugh.
Go back and talk to the blacksmith about the girl. Ask him to watch over her because it's what she wants. When you're done, quit and continue to reset the world state.
Back already. No matter. The girl. What about? Out of your mind. Who'd stay with an ugly brute? Absurd. I refuse to believe it. I don't doubt you, but I...
If you pick the correct dialogue choices, the girl will be sitting on the floor. Now we can fast travel back to Stormhill Shack. Now that the girl has moved back to the Round Table Hold, we can grab the golden seed she left in the shack. We can get more runes from the coffins up ahead. Just watch out for the enemies made of stone because they explode when we get too close. fast travel to Stormvale's main gate. Speak with the NPC and tell him that we want to enter the castle using the main gate.
You there? Come over here, would you? Your tie would advise against tightly guarded. Try the opening. The guards don't know you'll breach the castle. Fair enough. Well, if you... But of course, I'd advise...
The trick to pushing through the main gate is to follow the layout of the items on the ground. Sprint to the one closest to us, then to the one on the left. After that, run directly to the small flame on the right and crouch. This will help you avoid the arrows. When the enemies stop firing arrows, follow my path exactly to avoid getting hit by the second volley. When you finally clear the archers, take the long way around the courtyard to avoid the next enemy. Once you reach the archway, it'll be safe to turn around and kill the enemy for a level 1 somber smithing stone. Activate the Limgrave Tower Bridge Site of Grace. Follow me to the next Site of Grace. It's possible to skip the enemies, but the safe play is to kill as many of them as possible. Follow the path outside and speak with the NPC. Make sure to exhaust her dialogue before moving on.
Be proud. You are a fine warrior. Well, who do we have here? Tarnished, are you? I am Nefeli Lu. I'm here by decree of my father. How utterly repellent this grafting of Godric's ill, but he's tainted the very winds. If you intend to challenge Godric, I ask you call upon me. The winds run foul with his... I'm certain father would permit me. Apologies. As fellow Tarnished, we down whatever road takes us to the... Apologies, as fellow Tarnished, down whatever road to...
Grab the golden seed around the corner and kill the enemies blocking our path. Rest at the next side of grace in the room to the right just before the fog gate. Replenish our flask 3 times, then allocate 2 red flasks and 7 blue. Summon the NPC and kill the boss. We can use the same strategy as before. Summon, get some distance, and spam Rock Sling. Kill this boss to pop another trophy, plus we'll get a great rune, which will set us up perfectly for the next trophy.
home, bathed in rays of gold.
Travel back to Limgrave Tower Bridge. Run down the path on the right side to avoid the first few enemies. When you reach the destroyed part of the bridge, wait for the archer to fire one arrow, then make a break for the portal. Climb the tower and restore power to the Great Rune to pop the next trophy. Fast travel back to the lake facing cliffs, and I'll see you in episode 6. Be good.